to the 2021 Ottawa Economic Outlook. The Ottawa Board of Trade, Ottawa Business Journal, the City of Ottawa, and our partners have been hosting this event for local business and community leaders since 2012. In the last 8 years, we have heard from economists, executives, and thought leaders from Ottawa and across the country. Our goal is to share information and inspiration so that we may collectively and proactively plan the economic growth of Ottawa in the best way possible, inclusively and sustainably.
Throughout these challenging months, the pandemic has taught us one thing, that we are stronger together. Everyone here today is part of Ontario's future prosperity. We know there is more work to be done, and we're committed to continuing to support small businesses and our economy so we can rebuild the downtown core such as this one. And we know, thanks to the work of the Ottawa Board of Trade, we are laying the groundwork for economic recovery here in Ottawa. Together, we're also building a stronger Ontario.
The Mayor's Economic Partners Task Force, of which I am a co-chair, first convened in March 2022. It continues to play a leading role in our economic recovery, with partners bringing invaluable insight and expertise to the table. As a result of those conversations, we've delivered several initiatives and marketing campaigns to support small businesses in our community and promote tourism and buying local.
We've certainly seen our fair share of push and pull in terms of optimism and anxiety over where things are at economically at the firm. For example, we've seen, strong deal flow in terms of transactions in the small business arena. There's certainly capital out there to be deployed, and that's a great sign. At the same time, we've seen interesting times with respect to landlord and tenant relationships, estate planning, and people thinking about sort of mortality, and just trying to come to grips with all of the uncertainty that seems to continue to swirl about us.
Supply chain disruptions, shortages, bottlenecks are probably the leading source of economic uncertainty, economic anxiety. Whether it is shortages of widgets or workers, it clearly is having a major impact on people's perceptions of how strong the economy is and where the economy is going. And you get a sense of just how profound these bottlenecks are across all industries, across all sectors. And I liken it almost to a game of whack-a-mole, because as soon as you deal with one bottleneck popping up and another one sort of pops its head up, and you have to deal with that. And it seems to me that the issue here is this combination of very strong demand and supply always trying to catch up, but because global supply chains are still recovering from the pandemic, it's getting harder and harder for inflation not to increase as a result.
BMO has a long history of sponsoring the Ottawa's Economic Outlook, and we're very proud to sponsor today's luncheon. As we discover the best next steps for Ottawa today, I'd like to reiterate BMO's commitment to supporting our communities and businesses throughout the twists and turns of the recovery. We know how the pandemic has impacted the capital, and we're aware of the challenges ahead, but our strong commitment to this region remains unyielding, and BMO is ready to help our customers and communities to regain momentum by seizing the moment with economic rebounding.
Cities exist because of commercial life. That's why we have cities. People wanted to exchange, they wanted to trade, they wanted to have some engagement with one another. So at the heart of every city is an economy. And similarly, at the heart of every city are a series of communities, and at the heart of those communities are economies. So you're going to see as I talk the kinds of approaches that we've been taking to responding to the challenge of COVID, but also responding to the impacts of what we've been doing to contain COVID. So there's a number of things that are happening that have happened over the last 20 months. You've all experienced it, and you're all living it. And as the our my esteemed colleague from BMO said, and one of those slides suggested, these aren't going to be fast fixes. There are tons and tons of challenges that existed in cities pre-COVID that COVID exacerbated or accelerated or suddenly made us notice, and they're not going to get fixed overnight. So vaccines, yes, all the kinds of public health measures we're taking, yes, but there are all sorts of fundamental challenges in cities that people like us need to be coming to terms with. So again, these are the kinds of statistics you guys live with. You know specifically what your office space vulnerability is. Your biggest tenant, is the big bad government of Canada, and they're not coming home in a big hurry. Well, no, that's wrong. They're staying home, and they're not actually coming back into the office as quickly as we might like. So there's a good question, I think. A good question for me to ask you is, what kind of a priority are you going to place on trying to get the government of Canada to come back, A, or B, to diversify your commercial tenant mix so that you're not in that situation again where you had a predominant monoculture tenant mix and that left you in the situation. So part of what we're doing at CUI is trying to imagine new uses for downtowns. So does that mean, for instance, we're going to look at some commercial conversions into residential or into light manufacturing or into creative spaces? All these, it's all up for grabs. And we need to be really smart because the greatest assets you've got are all these buildings. So the challenge for you is to find your way to be the collaborative leaders to say, we own this. We own this problem. We own these assets. The space is fantastic to illustrate that to you. And that we're going to leverage and do the very best we can to involve everyone in all the different assets and then get on a path, a shared collective path. And government will come with you if you can do it.